together, may your spirit work within us. As we gather, may we glorify your name, knowing well that as our hearts begin to worship, we'll be blessed because we can. We'll be blessed because we can. The strength
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Today is the 26th Sunday in ordinary time. The theme for today's Eucharistic celebration, True Tolerance. In the first proclamation from the book of Numbers, the Lord bestows his spirit on the 70 elders. The responsorial Psalm 19 is a psalm of David, which says that the precepts of the Lord bring joy to the heart. In the second proclamation from St. James, he chastises the rich. In the Gospel from St. Mark, Jesus teaches his disciples that whoever is not against him is for him. Jesus acknowledges that deeds of faith can precede the words of faith. He also teaches that the disciples should not be reluctant to share Jesus' healing powers with others. Let us pray that we will not indulge in comparing ourselves to others, nor create obstacles for those who are just beginning to have faith, but encourage even the smallest signs of faith we see in people. As we continue to participate in the Holy Mass from the shelter of our homes, let us pray for the whole world, that slavery and social injustice will be wiped out, and that we will be able to live freely in peace and harmony with each other, trusting in the Lord at all times, and receive the sacrament of Holy Communion spiritually into our hearts, with faith, love, and reverence.
Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess
to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask the Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Glory to God in the highest.
And on earth peace to people of goodwill.
We praise you. We bless you. We adore you. We glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory.
Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father,
Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son,
Lord God, Lamb of God,
Son of the Father,
you take away the sins of the world,
have mercy on us.
You take away the sins of the world,
receive our prayer.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father,
have mercy on us.
For you alone are the Holy One,
you alone are the Lord,
you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ,
with the Holy Spirit,
in the glory of God the Father.
Amen.
Let us pray.
O God, who manifest your almighty power above all by pardoning and showing mercy, bestow, we pray, your grace abundantly upon us, and make those hastening to attain your promises heirs to the treasures of heaven. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Numbers. In those days, the Lord came down in the cloud and spoke to him, and took some of the spirit that was on him, and put it on the 70 elders. And as soon as the spirit rested on them, they prophesied. But they did not continue doing it. Now two men remained in the camp, one named Eldad, and the other named Medad, and the spirit rested on them. They were among those registered, but they had not gone out to the tent, and so they prophesied in the camp. And a young man ran and told Moses, "Eldad and Medad are prophesying in the camp." And Joshua, the son of Nun, the assistant of Moses from his youth, said, "My lord Moses, stop them." But Moses said to him, "Are you jealous for my sake? Would that all the Lord's people were prophets, that the Lord would put his spirit on them." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Psalm, your response. The precepts of the Lord are right. They gladden the heart.
The precepts of the Lord are right. They gladden the heart.
The law of the Lord is perfect. It revives the soul. The decrees of the Lord are steadfast. They give wisdom to the simple.
The precepts of the Lord are right. They gladden the heart.
The fear of the Lord is pure, abiding forever. The judgments of the Lord are true. They are, all of them, just.
The precepts of the Lord are right. They gladden the heart.
So in them your servant finds instruction. Great reward is in their keeping. But who can detect their own errors? From hidden faults, acquit me.
The precepts of the Lord are right. They gladden the heart.
From presumption, restrain your servant. May it not rule me. Then shall I be blameless, clean from grave sin.
The precepts of the Lord are right. They gladden the heart.
A reading from the letter of St. James. Come now, you rich, weep and howl for the miseries that are coming upon you. Your riches have rotted, and your garments are moth-eaten. Your gold and silver have corroded, and their corrosion will be evidence against you, and will eat your flesh like fire. You have laid up treasure in the last days. Behold, the wages of the laborers who mowed your fields, which you kept back by fraud, are crying out against you. And the cries of the harvesters have reached the ears of the Lord of hosts. You have lived on the earth in luxury and in self-indulgence. You have fattened your hearts in a day of slaughter. You have condemned and murdered the righteous person. He does not resist you. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please rise for the gospel acclamation. Your word, O Lord, is truth. Sanctify us in the truth.
Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, Lord.
At that time, John said to Jesus, "Teacher, we saw someone casting out demons in your name, and we tried to stop him because he was not following us." But Jesus said, "Do not stop him, for no one who does a mighty work in my name will be able soon afterwards to speak evil of me. For the one who is not against us is for us. For truly, I say to you, whoever gives a cup of water to drink because you belong to Christ will by no means lose his reward. Whoever causes one of these little ones who believe in me to sin, it would be better for him if a great millstone were hung around his neck and he were thrown into the sea. And if your hand causes you to sin, cut it off. It is better for you to enter life crippled than with two hands to go to hell. And if your foot causes you to sin, cut it off. It is better for you to enter life lame than with two feet to be thrown into hell. And if your eye causes you to sin, tear it out. It is better for you to enter the kingdom of God with one eye than with two eyes to be thrown into hell, where their worms does not die and the fire is not quenched." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise be to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My dear brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ, I want to tell you the story of Zing the zebra. There lived a family of zebras, father, mother, and two little zebras. Sister was Zink, brother was Fink. So Zink the zebra was a noble zebra. She had four legs, one tail, two ears, two eyes, and spots. Yes, she was different. Instead of stripes, she had spots. All the other little zebras didn't want to play with her, because she was different. One day, Fink the brother came to his sister and told, "You are weird because you are having spots instead of stripes." And Zing the zebra said, "No, you are weird. You are having stripes." So they were arguing and started fighting. And nobody was there to tell who is right and who is wrong. So they came running to their parents, and the parents told, "You are different, and that is what makes you special." And both of them were happy and they went to play. Now this is a simple story, but if you know the background behind this story, it's not simple. It was written by an 11-year-old girl called Kelly, who was battling with cancer. She died in 1993. When she was diagnosed with cancer and she had to go through painful treatment for cancer, she started losing her hair, started limping, became pale. So the other children did not want to associate with her. They did not want to play with her because they thought that this is contagious. They rejected her. After her death, her father found her diary, and in the diary, he found that she has written this story. It is a reflection of the pain that she underwent because she was rejected by the others, simply because she was different. She had told her teachers that the pain of rejection by her own friends is more painful than the agonizing cancer treatment that she was undergoing. The father was moved by this story. And later, he found this Zing the Zebra Foundation. Their mission is to teach tolerance and acceptance among children. Dear friends, today our readings also place us a lesson on tolerance and acceptance. In a world where we experience a lot of fragmentation, divisions, simply because the others are different from us, we need the story of Zing the Zebra to teach our children, teach our leaders, and teach us that we need to accept each other even though they are different from us. Our first reading is taken from the book of Numbers, chapter 11. We have an incident there. The story is told that Moses was fed up with the people of Israel. They were nagging, they were complaining, they were murmuring, they want meat on one time and vegetable on another time. They want manna and then they get fed up. So they started grumbling and murmuring and complaining. Moses was fed up. And he went to God and said, "Lord, it is enough. Did I conceive these people? Why am I facing all these complaints from these people? Now it is enough. I cannot bear anymore. Let me die. I don't want to have anything to do with these people." And the Lord said, "Okay, I will ease your burden. Let us appoint assistants for you, delegates to carry out your work among the people. So you select 6 from each tribe." 12 tribes, 12 into 6, 72. And Moses was instructed to bring these 72 for the assembly, where the Spirit of God will be given to them. They will be officially recognized, inducted, and the Spirit of the Lord will be given to them. So on the appointed day, everybody gathered around the mountain of the Lord, and the Spirit descended upon them. But unfortunately, 2 were missing. Only 70 were present. Eldad and Medad. Either they had a long sleep, they forgot, overslept, we do not know. They were not present. They were back in the camp, not in the assembly. And when that 70 received the Spirit of the Lord and started prophesying and praising God, somebody came running from the camp and said, "Look, Eldad and Medad also received the Spirit." And Moses' assistant and successor, Joshua, was offended. He came running to Moses and said, "Look here, now this should not be happening. You better stop them because they are not with us. They did not come on time. They are not in the assembly. Therefore, stop them." And Moses says, "Who am I to stop? Can I control the Spirit of the Lord? If they, oh, then the whole world started prophesying in the name of the Lord, can I stop that?" The Spirit of the Lord blows where it wills. We cannot domesticate it. We cannot control it. The Lord gives His Spirit to whom He wills. This is a lesson that Moses learned, and this is a lesson that Joshua is taught on that day. We have the same dynamics in our gospel today. John comes running to Jesus and tells, "Look here, there is a man who is casting out demons in your name. He's not with us, he's not following us, but he's using your name." So John accepts that these are real demons, and this man is doing real work, and is using the name of Jesus. But still, he says, "Stop him, Lord, because he is not one with us." Now, this is what we call turf wars. Caste mentality, tribal mentality, regionalism, caste-minded, creed-minded, language-based discrimination. This is where all around us. We get offended when someone is doing good, and especially that someone is not one of us. The good is happening not through the channels accepted by us. A good is done out of the structures established by us. This lesson of tolerance today challenges us to accept good wherever it is, and encourage that good wherever that is, because we believe in a God who is all good. He is the source of all good and goodness. So wherever you find good that comes from God, accepting that good and truth is to accept that God's working even beyond the confined boundaries that we have set up. We need to accept in the first place that all of us, irrespective of who we are, have the right to thought. We can think the way that we want, and we can arrive at the conclusions with the knowledge and the experience that all of us have. It is unique to each and every one of us. Based on that thinking, that behavior, that particular tradition, we cannot discriminate anyone. The reason is that all of us bear the image of God within us. The goodness exists even outside the established structures, even beyond our limits. Therefore, on the basis of one's thinking behavior, we cannot suppress, oppress, or discriminate anyone. And that is a lesson that we need to teach our children in a very special way. My dear brothers and sisters, there are three truths in the world: my truth, your truth, and the truth. Each one looks at the world in a different way. We have our own world views, and that is what makes the world beautiful. There is diversity, and we need to celebrate that diversity. We agree to disagree. We can sit together, even though you speak a different language, even though you belong to a different tradition. Still, we all belong to the human family, and God is our Father. That lies as the basis for tolerance. But a word of caution: tolerance does not mean that you endorse a person's action. Now Jesus sat with the sinners, tax collectors, he ate with them, associated with them, but he never sinned with them. We may condemn person's action, but we can never condemn that person. Sin, certainly we have to condemn. We cannot accept sin in any form. But the sinner, we need to accept. We need to make a distinction between the action and the person. The truth and love should go hand in hand. If there are chemists here and the students who are learning chemistry, you know that sodium is a very strong element. It cannot stand on its own. It's very strong. So it always combines with another element. In the same way, chlorine, it has that foul smell. But you put sodium and chlorine together, you make sodium chloride, the normal table salt. It gives us flavor, it preserves food, and have variety of uses. Love and truth are like sodium and chlorine. On their own, they can be very strong. Sometimes it's hard to digest when the truth is presented to us. Truth is bitter. It's strong. It has to be coupled with love always. Love without truth is blind. And truth without love can be poisonous and bitter. So when we present the truth to somebody or accept the truth from somebody, it has always to be combined with love. And that is a lesson that the leaders, all of us, especially our children, have to learn. And today, Jesus places that lesson for the disciples and for all of us today. Let us ask the Lord to open up our minds and hearts. Let our truth be combined with love. Now let us profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth,
of all things visible and invisible.
I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead, and the life of the world to come. Amen. Now let us place our intentions before the Lord and pray in faith.
Your response, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our Holy Father, Pope Francis, Archbishop Malcolm Cardinal Ranjit, all bishops, priests, deacons, and religious, may they continue to work alongside people of different denominations and faiths and guide those who struggle to reject all that is evil in their lives, and lead them to the way of repentance and salvation. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
In today's proclamations, we are called to reflect on how we live our daily lives. Help us to live righteously and go beyond our circle of friends, to reach out to the needy, so that by our actions we may encourage others to believe in God. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have let possessions lead them away from God, help them to be aware of the graces and gifts of God and thirst for heavenly inheritance by leading a humble and true Christian life. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those in the medical profession, frontline workers, and the security forces, may they continue their untiring work with dedication and compassion, caring for the sick and the dying. Give them strength and courage, and may they be guided by the Holy Spirit as they face dangerous situations during this pandemic. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray silently for our personal intentions. Especially remember to pray for all those who have asked us to pray, for their various needs and intentions. People who are celebrating important events in their life, their birthdays, their anniversaries. Those who are starting important projects over the course of the week, facing interviews. The children studying and sitting for various exams. And all those our benefactors who help us, especially to record and telecast this Mass. All those who come forward to help us in organizing the liturgy. God, our loving Father, we place these intentions and all those untold desires and worries in our heart. We know you are a God of infinite goodness and love, and we trust only on that infinite goodness and love, and we surrender ourselves, our future, and all that we are to our divine will and ask for this grace. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father,
may the Lord accept your sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Grant us, O merciful God, that this our offering may find acceptance with you, and that through it the wellsprings of all blessing may be laid open before us. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For we know it belongs to your boundless glory that you came to the aid of mortal beings with your divinity, and even fashioned for us a remedy out of mortality itself, that the cause of our downfall might become the means of our salvation. Through him, the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in humble chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim:
Holy, 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 holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Again, he gave you thanks and praise, gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Malcolm Ranjit our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by the divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation,
but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin, safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world,
have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world,
have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Dear friends, at this moment, prepare yourself to receive Jesus spiritually. Ask the Lord to give us His Spirit and open your hearts and minds, and especially your family, and surrender to the Eucharistic Lord at this moment and pray earnestly.
My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Lord, I come to you. Let my heart be changed.
Stripped away by the power.
also with you. Your spirit leads me on by the power of your love. Lord, unveil my eyes, let me see you face.
Let us pray. May this heavenly mystery, O Lord, restore us in mind and body, that we may be co-heirs in glory with Christ, to whose suffering we are united whenever we proclaim his death, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.